Hey, my name is Mohammed. I run the blog called dentalschoolcoach.com where I help pre-dental students get into their dream dental school. This video is about my own personal statement. In this video, I'm gonna go really deep into the personal statement and tell you what's good about it and what's bad about it. It's not a flawless draft. It has some of its own mistakes, but overall it's a good enough draft that got me into Penn, UCSF, UMDNJ, Pittsburgh, and NYU. So I would, you know, pay close attention to some of the psychological triggers I've used. Also, when you read it, you can get the link under my signature. Read it with, focusing what stories I tell and how I tell the stories. Those are very important. Let's go right in. This is, this is a personal statement. You'll see many stories in this. You know, I don't just tell one story and loop back to it at the end. I tell multiple stories to give the reader glimpses of my life at different times. And it worked really well, it really worked well for me. For some people, they don't like to tell multiple stories. They just want to say, they just want to use one story and want to loop back to that story at the end. That is also fine. You know, there is no single way of writing a personal statement, so make sure that when you write one, try different approaches, see what works for you. Secondly, I use, in the second paragraph, I use financial struggle as one of my character-defining, experience. And if you may know that to become a good dentist, you must be patient and perseverance. And I bring that right in the second paragraph, right into the second paragraph. I mentioned that, because of my financial struggle, I have gained perseverance and patience ingrained in me. Now, a lot of people might say, oh, this is cheesy and whatnot. Yeah, that's fine. But the thing that I want you to take home is that if you define experiences in your personal statement, or if you write stories about something in your personal statement that defines your characteristic, that makes you who you are today, it's absolutely very important to mention. For me, it was my financial struggle. For some people, it might be just the death of a close person, or there are many stories you can tell that defines your characteristic. And any characteristic that is that will make you a good dentist, definitely put that in your personal statement. Going into the third paragraph, I've done something that I don't see many people doing in their personal statement. This is what I see in many people's personal statement. A lot of people would write how gracious their dentist is, or how generous, compassionate their dentist is, and it inspired them to become a dentist. That's perfectly fine. You should mention that if you found a dentist to be absolutely amazing. However, you should also look back and talk about yourself. And mention that you also have those soft qualities, soft skills that will make you a good dentist. For example, I mentioned that through one of the experiences I had, I volunteered volunteered at a refugee camp where I helped out Somali refugee kid named Abdi. I helped him to get a scholarship program at Syracuse University. That's showing compassion. That's showing generosity to someone who doesn't have that access to help. So if you have qualities, if you have characteristic traits through experiences you had in your life, or through experiences you are continuing to do in at the moment, make sure you mention that in your personal statement. It's valuable. The readers are going to absolutely love that. Do not shy away from mentioning something that, some ingrained qualities you have. A personal statement is a sales copy, basically. You have to sell yourself. And if you've come short in selling yourself, there might be someone else who would be doing a better job selling himself, and you won't get in. Now, going to the third paragraph, it's about leadership experiences, about one of the clubs that I started at Penn. Now, what I want you to take out from this paragraph is that I don't just talk about what I've done. A lot of people would just stop at, oh, I've done X, Y, and Z. That's boring, What you need to do is write about your experiences and learning points, and write about the results you had. Write about what impact you created at the at the extracurricular activities you did. For example, I've hosted an event with 150 people does not make me impressed about your accomplishment. But if you say that, well, I've made changes in someone's life, I've taught her how to do X, Y, and Z, or I have, you know, made sure that she got into X, Y, and Z program, or she got a scholarship at, you know, this school and that school. That's a bigger accomplishment you have, and you should mention that. If you do some extracurricular activities or volunteer activities, you know, make sure you talk about impact more than what you did. Going into the paragraph where I talk about sculpture and then my lab work, you know, a lot of people made fun of me because I used clay bosom of Abraham Lincoln. That was a mistake. I now understood. Back then, I didn't have any idea, and I'm guessing that dental school were much more forgiving about that. Anyways, going into the sculpture class, I don't just talk about what I did at the sculpture course. I talk about a specific project I've done, and I also talk about how much hard work I put into it. Dental schools love to see people working hard because that's, you know, in dental school, it's not going to be easy. People that work hard will stick, and people that don't put that much effort are not going to stick. So they want to see someone who is working hard and, you know, can work hard throughout the dental school. And finally, in the lab work, I don't mention anything about what I did in the lab. And it's not important, you know, they'll ask you what you've done in the lab if you get an interview. But what I mentioned is that I got a paper published. There was no place I could put that down, and it's a significant accomplishment that I had. A lot of undergraduates I've seen, they don't have a paper published in a highly impact organic journal or high impact any kind of journal. So it makes me stand out instantly. Now, you know, you can mention that, oh, you're just bragging about yourself. Isn't that what the intention of a personal statement? Also, you know, you should. I'm not coming across as arrogant here. I'm trying to come across as someone who put a lot of work in and is just proud of the effort that I put in. You know, so that's it about my personal statement. One final point: when you write the conclusion, make sure that your last statement is catchy. For example, here I talk about how I vow to stay patient, stay focused. Now, this is something I copied from Steve Jobs. When he was giving a commencement speech at Stanford, he said, stay foolish, stay hungry. I copied that and I put, stay focused, stay patient. It's catchy. It makes the reader remember you more. And, you know, at the end of the day, it's all about if the reader is going to remember you and recommend you for an interview. Anyways, that's all about my personal statement. If you have any question about personal statement, shoot me an email at this email address. This is my personal email address. And if, you know, feel free to visit my site, dentalschoolcoach.com. I'm going to put out more blog posts, more videos, and, you know, much more tricks and tactics to get into dental school. Until then, take care. Bye.